Writing documentation means updating Markdown files. I find it really frustrating to fix a typo through an IDE because IDE was optimized to work with code and not with content. But is there a better way? My name is Sylwia Vargas, and I'm a developer advocate at StackBlitz. I want to talk to you about building documentation with Next.js. Many of you are familiar with Nextra, a static site generator used for docs and blogs based on Next.js. Say you wanted your users to instantly try your project out. You could embed an interactive example onto the page. Our community has created some stunning work with our embeds. Just look at these gorgeous examples of pages and courses. So let's do it together. But I am not a contributor or maintainer of Nextra, so I need to fork and clone the repository, install the dependencies, resolve possible conflicts, and run the dev server. Or do I? I have a surprise for you. To edit this page, let's find edit this page on GitHub link. Okay, I'll click on it and no, this is a Markdown file. It's not helping me. I don't know how these changes are gonna look. Okay, let's click on the preview and frustrating. It doesn't look anything like my page. And it cannot look like my page because there is no dev server running. To see how these changes are going to be rendered on my page, I need to clone the repository, run the dependencies, and run the dev server. This is a lot of work for one small change. Okay, let's try something else. Let's go back to our homepage and let's try adding pr.new to this link. What will happen? Will it work? I don't know. Let's see. Can I click it? Let's see what happens. Web publisher, everyone. It is a tool designed to make content creation and content updates friendly. On the left, you see an editor. On the right, there is the dev server already running. As I type, it updates. I can instantly see how my changes will look on the page. And the best part? Well, it can work with any framework and it is free for open source projects. So let's add the interactive example, shall we? Okay, adding an iframe, pasting the URL, and done. Looking good? Yes, it is. Our embed is ready, so let's submit a PR. As I click on this button, web publisher will do all the heavy lifting for me. It will fork the repo, commit my work, push the changes, and prepare a PR. And that's it. Ready. Done. Web publisher is not only for blogs or docs. You can edit any page, your landing page or your marketing page. You can invite your non-technical colleagues to join in the fun. Think about your marketing colleague or your friendly designer friend. Oh, even my mom can now edit our landing page. There is more. Now that our PR is ready, we can use another tool called CodeFlow IDE to review it. What is CodeFlow IDE? Well, it's your entire code editor running inside your browser. One click, and that's it. It's there. Again, the handy short URL pr.new. Let's add it to the beginning of the URL of this PR, and a whole IDE boots up. You see the dependencies being installed. The PR is ready to be reviewed. You can browse the files, you can check the changes, you can add comments. There's even a bot that you can install that will prep everything for you with just one click. It will detect a PR or an issue with a StackBlitz reproduction and then prepare an IDE for you so that you can inspect it and review it. No more stashing your changes, no more dealing with dependencies. It's all in your browser. But what is this magic, you may ask? Well, let me tell you. A year ago at Google I/O, we launched Web Containers. It is a technology that enables you to run Node.js inside your browser. So now that we have that, we created a tool that makes docs editing easier. But we know that there is nothing like trying it yourself. So we created a page for you. Go to ilovecodeflow.com and add your name. Then on the PR that you created, check out Codeflow App Bot. Click on that link and review your PR. See it for yourself. I am so excited for you to try it out and to faster make the web faster. It's 2022 and you deserve friendly documentation experiences. So go to ilovecodeflow.com and try it yourself. Make Codeflow your workflow. Let me know what you think on Twitter or on Discord. I would love to hear from you. Thank you for listening.